All the posterior base flaps have to be muscle bone, and all the anterior base flaps have to be only mucosa bone. By doing that, we can move the entire musculature here posteriorly and inferiorly so that the velopharyngeal incompetence becomes better. So now if you see, there's this much of a distance at rest, muscle and the posterior pharyngeal wall, okay? After surgery you will see. So the first procedure is to put a stay on the uvula. Okay, come like this. So this is the junction of a hard and soft palate where this thing stops. Somebody said, that's what I'm looking back. Yeah, that's correct. The hole there, through and through. Okay, and I come anteriorly. Okay, I come anteriorly. Now I need knife. Knife, please. We have this flap, we would call it flap 1. This is mucosomuscular. Because it's got muscle attached on it, it's going to be posteriorly based. There you see, it's posteriorly based. Okay, we move on to the flap 2. So this is pretty much mucosal because it's anteriorly based. Thank you. varices irukka. Not doing very well. Something in between. That's your flap 2 now. I said it, mucosal, it probably also has a little bit of fat or some glands beneath, but all the muscles on the other flap. This is our flap 2. This is now muscle and mucosa beneath. So this is going to be my very important flap. So I'm going to use, you see? That's my third flap. And this is just the mucosa, so it's going to be placed anteriorly. Two, four, six, five. So that's pretty much the basic dissection. Now we're going to get the flap 3 in the slot created by flap. That's the end of the flap 3. This flap, you see there, right at the base. So remember, this flap was from here. So we've taken the bulk of the muscles already down by an inch. quadrant. Delicate. So this is our first lap. So it goes from here, it's going back there now. The 2, 4, 6, 7. So that's our second flap. That's come anteriorly. Only has the mucosa, essentially no muscle. Yeah. So you see there's some dead space kind of a thing that's created there. So sometimes I put PRF membrane in there. So that fills up the defect, and this patient we haven't made it ready. The length that you've got for the soft palate and flexibility and everything. So like I said, done well, you have this advantage. The only disadvantage that could be is that if not executed well, you can get a fistula. So that could be an issue for some. Thank you. craniofacial. So that's the pharyngeal wall now, and the newer marking is somewhere there. So this is the current distance from the pharyngeal wall to the soft palate musculature. This was the current distance. So just by the surgery, we've enabled the muscles not only to be re-anastomosed in a much better fashion that could function more efficiently, but we've also taken it inferiorly and posteriorly. So this is one of the main reasons why this speech surgery works that efficiently for all patients who have a VPI. Thank you.